Let's say I have the number 905.074. So how could I expand this out? What does this actually represent? So let's just think about each of the place values here. The 9 right over here, this is in the hundreds place. This literally represents 9 hundreds. So we could rewrite that 9 as 9 hundreds, or let me write it two ways. We could write it as 900, which is the same thing as 9 times 100. Now this is 0, that's just going to represent 0 tens, but 0 tens is still just 0, so we don't have to really worry about that. It's not adding any value to our expression or to our number. Now we have this 5. This 5 is in the ones place. It literally represents 5 ones, or you could just say it represents 5. Now if we wanted to write it as 5 ones, we could say, well, that's going to be 5 times 1. So far we've represented 905. 900 plus 5, or 9 times 100 plus 5 times 1. And you might say, hey, how do I know whether I should multiply or add first? Should I do this addition before I do this multiplication? And I'll always remind you, order of operations, in this scenario, you would do your multiplication before you do your addition. So you would multiply your 5 times 1 and your 9 times 100 before adding these two things together. But let's move on. You have another 0. This 0 is in the tenths place. This is telling us the number of tenths we're going to have. This is 0 tenths, so it's really not adding much. Or it's not adding anything. Now we go to the hundredths place. The hundredths place. So this literally represents 7 hundredths. So we could write this as 7 hundredths, or 7 times 1 hundredth. So plus 7 times 1 hundredth. And then finally, we go to the thousandths place. So we go to the thousandths place. And we have 4 thousandths. So that literally represents 4/1,000, or 4 times 1,000th. 4 times 1,000th. Notice, this is coming from the hundredths place. This is coming from the hundredths place. You have 0 tens, but I'll write the tens place there just so you see it. So it's 0 tens, so I didn't even bother to write that down. Then you have your ones place, you have 5 ones. Then you have 0 tenths, so I didn't write that down. Then you have 7 hundredths, and then you have 4 thousandths. So, and we are done. We've written this out, really just understanding what this number represents.